right. Okay, everyone, this is Grant from Spark Sites and State of the Spark. You guys have been paying attention to some of the business owners we're interviewing, and today I'm super pumped to have a good friend, and we've worked together on small things here or there. This is Chris Hinojosa, and I have Chris on because he and Monet from Light Up Digital Marketing are doing something really cool that I want to tell you about. So background on Chris. So Chris and I are like, whenever we get together for coffee, it turns into like mad scientist lab, and like we're always talking about different ways that like, you know how it goes, how we can take over the world, but really how we can serve people. And Chris's specialty has been building marketing and marketing funnels for awesome clients like GNC and a variety of people over time. But when the market corrected, he and MMA at Light Up Marketing, Digital Marketing, were serving Marcos at 1961. And if anyone's been to Lakeland and hasn't visited 1961, they're missing something in a big way. I love going there, but these guys serve from a marketing perspective there. When the market changed, they obviously saw what all of you saw, and that was like a big scramble to rebuild people's, especially restaurants, funnel and how they were serving people. And Chris and Monet have really been able to serve 1961 and other people very well, but that gave birth to Support Lakeland, and that's what we're here to talk about. So SupportLakeland.com, SupportLKLD, and Support Lakeland as an app. So I've got Chris on to tell us a bit. Chris, tell us about Support Lakeland and how that's serving, I guess, consumers and restaurant owners. So take it away. Tell us about Support Lakeland, man.
For sure. And first of all, thank you for having me on. I really appreciate it. And yeah, hello to everybody in the Spark Nation. Like you said, 1961 is one of our clients, and they're, you know, a restaurant client, a food client. We have some other retail clients as well. And so everybody was feeling the market correction, you know, early March. That's when the news started to really kind of come in that, you know, there were some restrictions being placed. And especially it was very abrupt more in other states, Kentucky, Ohio, Tennessee, California, New York, especially. And so a lot of people were watching the news, the national news, and thinking that those policies in other states were happening exactly, that they applied here immediately. The interesting thing is it's a state by state issue actually. And so the governor has been reluctant to impose a lot of those very strict things. And so the rollout for this, social distancing, as it's now been termed, has been very gradual for us here in Florida, especially in Lakeland. I think I even saw today, and so today's, Tuesday, March 31st at the time of this recording, that the city is actually starting to relax some of those measures on some parks, right?
Yeah.
So some parks are actually going to start opening up again.
Yeah.
So it's
going to make the comments flare up. So
yeah, I know. Well, yeah. And all that to say that there's just it's ever changing, right?
Correct.
It's constant. So we're really trying to keep our thumb on the pulse of what these policies are. We want to respect the policies, but we also want to guide these business owners or at least our clients in the direction how to pivot, how to let people know, hey, we're still open. We're still open for business. All these local businesses, not just our clients, but everybody around and throughout the city, they rely on our patronage. They rely on our support. They're not closed down. You know, Marcos said, we had to shift our entire business into a delivery-based business.
Yep.
Because you can't have, right now, at least you can't have in restaurant dining, you know. So it's just really changed. You know, he has restaurateur friends who he says serve amazing food. They're very talented, but those who are not pivoting, those who are not changing with the market here because of the situation, they're not seeing the sales coming. And they could,
that's
the real message. They totally could. So we made this app, and I've talked a little bit about restaurateurs, but really this applies to retailers. This applies to gift shops. This applies to wellness, nutrition, everything, you know, that everybody that's still open for business, you know, Support Lakeland is a free web app. I break it down for two audiences of people. One is the everyday Lakelander, right?
Okay.
The person who is trying to go and get their Mitchell's coffee, get their Cuban sandwich from Divisha's, and then go and shop somewhere else. They're going to be able to find their favorite places in this app, right?
Okay.
The other
local
audience,
places.
Right. Local places. And then the other is for the business owner, right? So the business owner can actually go in, they can go on our website, supportlakeland.com. At the bottom, there's a little start application button. All they have to do is give us four questions, right? Mm-hmm. Four questions that we're asking so that we can get their listing started. We actually already filled in the information for about the first 40 businesses and found that that was actually a little taxing as far as the time invested. We were happy to do it, you know, but it's a lot to just aggregate all that info. But
if we can at least get menus and everything?
No, but we can enable that. You know, that's the cool thing is we can, if they give us those first four questions, we can at least get their listing started. Yeah. That gives them an email that's triggered so that they can get in. And that's the key, you know, with the platform we're using, because it's not a traditional app. You can't find it in the App Store. You can't find it in the Play Store.
You need to hit that link specifically.
Exactly. Add it to your home screen, all that good stuff. Mm-hmm. Once they do that, they're going to get access to their own listing. They can fill in the rest of the details. They can put in their Instagram link. They can put in their website, their phone number, their open hours, special notes. It even lets them check off. Do they have virtual shopping? Do they have online ordering? Do they have curbside to go? So all these different things will allow them to push that as an update to the public. It's important that people take care or take control of their Google listing as well. You know, that's super important.
Huge.
Not enough people are doing that.
They're not. What you would mention is there is a whole swath of local restaurants specifically, and I'm sure other companies, but we're paying attention to restaurants. Mm-hmm. There was a whole slew of them that have gotten by word of mouth, old school Lakeland for years. I'm thinking of the Purple Onion. I'm thinking of Gosh. I'm thinking of New Moon Sushi. And it's like they're struggling now. Fortunately, they have good fans, like in the Facebook group Rally Around Restaurants.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And like Jim Mosher, I know, goes over to Purple Onion, snaps photo of the daily soups and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. But it's not quick enough, for
Correct.
Sure.
Correct.
You know.
Correct. Yeah, and I've seen, you know, and so many people have tried to rally around supporting these local businesses during these times in the last few weeks. It's been amazing to see the support. But you know, we see emails come in from like LAL and they try and have, you know, they've got this list of updates, but then that's outdated by tomorrow because policies have changed. You know, then this other group has this list of Instagram stories, but those expire in 24 hours.
Yeah.
You know, so there's all this, you know, everybody's trying, but it gets fragmented. And so the unique thing about Support Lakeland web app is that it's all aggregated in one place and the updates are literally up to the minute.
Yeah. So I saw, give me an example here. Like I saw Black & Brew on Support Lakeland. Now Black & Brew is the opposite. They've done very well with Chow Now, online ordering, phone ordering. They've been ready for a while. And Chris, to his credit, Chris MacArthur, pivoted very quickly and was ready for that, but he can still benefit. Is that accurate? From Support Lakeland.
Correct. He can still benefit. We put a section in there called special notes. So that's anything extra beyond your, you know, your normal, if you're a restaurant, you're really going to take advantage of a lot of these check marks in here, like online ordering, curbside to go, all that normal stuff, plus your operating hours, you can change all of those. Then there's a special note section. So if there's really an update that you want people to know, for example, again, going back to 1961, I think they're closed today and tomorrow for doing all the sanitary stuff.
Cleaning,
And then they reopen, you know, so this is an interruption to their normal schedule. You know, they're not normally closed on a Tuesday and a Wednesday, but this week they are.
That's good. And I do have to say, completely aside from Support Lakeland, I have been massively impressed at what you and Mo have been able to do. And I've told this, like, to those watching, I've told this to Chris. We've run into each other at Black and Brew when some of this first started. And you guys have got to be given a lot of credit for the guidance you've been able to give Marcos and bringing his staff online. So, like props to you. I know you're not fishing for that, but like I have been
truly
impressed on what you guys have been able to do. I told Marcos this, and I'm telling you this. I want to see a Zoom MasterChef. And if the audience would like to see that, I want to see a Zoom MasterChef.
Okay.
And now that people are watching, the idea is floating around. So you guys got to
be
Marcos on that sooner than other people. But having customers try to maybe even recreate their favorite 1961 dish from home.
Yeah.
And it would just be stupid fun. And he could give away a dinner that night. But anyways, you guys have done really good supporting him. So I got to applaud you on that. So talk to me about adoption. Talk to me about adoption and usage statistics so far for you guys. Like, how's it going? How are people gravitating? Tell me about it.
Yeah, we've seen a slow adoption, and we're really just trying to get the word out there. You know, we've put it out to a lot of the major publications, but we really just haven't kind of heard back. So we were just recently featured on Jay Che's podcast.
So
he was very, very gracious to bring us on to talk about that. We're really just trying to spread. And again, this is a free resource to everybody.
You guys aren't monetizing it at all.
No, not looking to monetize. This is not, you know, one of those things. And there's other, you know, businesses that you could probably find online whose company's probably based in like California or Canada or somewhere that starts with a CA. And, you know, you'd have to pay something, you know. Subsplash is one of those platforms, and they provide a great platform, but you're going to have to pay. You know, we're just trying to provide this as a free resource because we need to be able to get through this somehow in this time. And, you know, I mean, we've heard that entire staffs have been laid off at different establishments, both food-based and non-food-based, whereas some other ones are not, and they're trying to figure a way to keep their staff on. So we've got to support these guys.
Well, and what you're seeing, and like you and I know that like in calmer times, we could like wax philosophical, and that is that we're seeing digitization being forced upon people. And the term for it's future shock. And a lot of these companies who, I know you're a technophile like I am, and you go to these companies and say, listen, I know you don't think it means much, but have even a one-page landing page. Get your Google business listing under control. Have a Facebook page and let it just sit there and collect dust. Why? We need it. We get word of mouth. Well, welcome to tomorrow, dude. Like, so I applaud you guys because it's almost like you're creating, like with a friend of mine, Nathaniel, he was cued into Purple Onion, and he was like, listen, I will build you for free a one-page landing page. I literally want you to stay alive. That's literally what I'm trying to do. Support Lakeland kind of creates a bit of a marketplace where it's making the digitization easier is what I'm saying. That which is being forced upon some of these companies that are behind, it's a salve and makes that transition easier is what it looks like. I mean, so what's next for Support Lakeland? You guys are just out there blasting the message. Is there any like feature updates? Or are you guys really just trying to stay in the moment and get people on there right now?
Yeah, trying to get as many people on there as possible. And again, the easiest way for business owners to do that is to go to the website supportlakeland.com, and you can spell it either way. But at the bottom, it says start application. You're just answering four questions. It helps us to copy paste, get your listing in there. An email will automate back to you with the link for the admin app. There's actually two apps. You know, there's the public app, which we encourage everybody to download, including business owners. But then there's a very special link for the admin app so that the restaurateur or the business owner is editing their own listing and nobody else's, you know?
Yeah.
So having access to that email account is very important. And some people are like, oh, I have to reset my password. Yeah, you should do that. Like right now, get a hold of your own accounts.
Yeah.
Now you guys are doing something as well. You have a Corona recovery page, or can you tell us more about that?
I appreciate you asking.
It's
a resource page. And
and
what I found was this. So, I mean, all of us, you, me, we're all looking for different ways to make these things easier. What we were finding is that in the feeds, like in Facebook and Instagram and all that, And the feeds, there's like all these references, or you could say resources, but they're all over the place. And we thought, listen, our passion as a business owner, we're catching a lot of flack because every time we see someone not lax their restrictions, but have reasonable restrictions, like I think Governor Cuomo in New York was even quoted as saying, listen, we shut everything down and there was probably no art to that. But I would recommend a pronged approach and a more artistic scalpeled approach where we're protecting at-risk populations, but also protecting our businesses, because a lot of public health, I say a lot, some public health officials that I've been reading after are saying, listen, it could be a bigger public health issue to shut the economy down. And there's some ripple effects and dominoes. Everyone's got their logic. Wherever people fall, where we fall is we support people's dreams and their businesses are super important. I say, let's say the recovery page says, listen, let's gather up the resources that might not keep businesses open per se, but keep them funded. So this SBA thing, where can you go for that? Well, I go to SBA here. Which of these links do I click? It's so confusing. I don't know. We have the right link. It's and like you with restaurants and Support Lakeland and other businesses, not just restaurants. With us, we see a lot of these companies trying to digitize with even Zoom. If people don't know Zoom 2 weeks into the self-quarantine, then we have those links of how to do this, how to work remotely. Like, can we help people shift to work remotely? We've been using Basecamp and Zoom and Google Meet for a long, long time. So we have some of those quick links. And then some of that, we did also throw health in there because what we've noticed too is as people have taken their work home, their wealth has gone out the window. I don't know about you, but we've tried to keep up, but it's really difficult to keep up with health and fitness for most folks while they're working out from home. So there's just those references. So it's just stateofthespark.com/corona recovery, or if you just go to stateofthespark.com, there's a link right at the top. We should look at putting a Support Lakeland link on there for restaurants. So we'll be sure to do that. For this video though, we'll put the link in the comments, and I'm sure if I miss anything, you can comment and add the right links below. But the goal is digitizing people as quickly as possible. And in your case, you're helping primarily restaurants, but other businesses as well. And then supporting them as quickly as possible, because like I heard one of these sushi companies, and I won't say who, they had reported to the person that I was talking to, who was also a restaurateur, that day they'd only sold $350 that day. And like as a business owner, I'm like, they have staff, people are getting furloughed. We can't stop all of that. I'm glad to see some of the relief efforts. I question what some of the ripple effects will be, but who cares? Yeah. For right now, we're doing triage. You guys are doing triage, which I applaud, and we're going to link to that. We're trying to do triage to corona recovery. And also, we're starting to do more and more posts as we get into the recovery and into like, okay, life's back to normal, but there's still repair work. We'll be launching more products and services and trainings on that page as well to support that. So I appreciate you bringing that up. But so let me ask this before we get out of here. Let me ask you. We know how you're adapting, right? And and you've adapted by creating Support Lakeland. Let me ask just a pin, if we could deviate just a hair. How are you adapting your marketing services for your clients at large?
So today we are out filming for a client. It's a big cleaning, you know, service, Surf Pro of Bartow Lakeland Highlands. They do a lot, you know, and one of the things that they do, and they're not just doing it because of COVID-19, but they've been doing it for a while, is, you know, deep cleaning stuff with hospital grade equipment, hospital grade cleaners.
That's good.
That's what, you know, not only are they allowed to message that, but that's exactly what they're using. You know, it's not the car detailer guy that you know, who probably does a good job at detailing your car, but he doesn't use hospital grade cleaners, you know. Most likely not. You know, if somebody has, you know, a cleaning staff or somebody who does house cleaning for them, or if they are a house cleaner themselves, you know, you're not using hospital grade stuff. These guys do. They do fire damage, water damage, all this stuff. So that's just the example from today, right? Yeah. We're helping them to, and because of this, they've been way more receptive to get on camera, which we both know when you have a face on camera, people in marketing will respond more to it. Yes. Yeah, exactly. Yes. Exactly. So a lot of our client, what we've been seeing, to answer your question, is that on-camera stuff, people have been way more receptive to.
Yeah.
They're starting to ask us more. I think we talked even about sort of, we turned into a little bit of a tech support because, you know, people were like, how do I, you know, while we were doing our thing right here, I had an email come in from a client who I'm going to have to call her because I'm helping her online shopping cart set up. She's never done online shopping cart before. So Everybody is finding the marketers to be the resources to help pivot the businesses, which is good, because even whenever it does, you know, go away and everything sort of normalizes out, I don't know when that's going to be, but when that does happen, these things are going to stay with them.
Stay. I believe. Yes, I totally agree with that.
The virus might go away, but the best practices won't.
I agree. It's almost like I am grateful for this. Like people, I mean, okay, so for all the tragedy, I empathize, I'm with you. But from a futurist perspective, I am grateful because you and I have been standing on soapboxes as long as we've known each other, that like I have a good buddy and he's a good friend and we know this guy and he is not online. And I've been telling him, my brother, you have got to make this transition. So this transition has forced this on people. And I have been saying to you, once the virus is gone, I will be so grateful and these companies will be grateful because they will have new lines of communication that they've never had before that we can celebrate and help them share what they're awesome about. Like your client Start Pro. I mean, that's a fantastic message that they should have been sharing anyway, you know?
Yes. Yeah.
Or might have been, but now have new presence for it.
Yeah. You know, they're really passionate, and that's not just them, but I'm going to use them as an example because this is true of any of our clients, any of my clients, your clients, I'm sure that, cause we're hearing it all around. They're very passionate about their business. They're very passionate about their excellence in their industry, but these guys get really camera shy, or when I say camera shy, it's not just in front of a camera, but they don't want to speak on their own behalf, you know, and this is forcing them to. This is forcing them out of that turtle shell or out from behind the curtain, you know, and somebody has to see the Wizard of Oz.
Yes.
So there he is now, you know.
Well, and it's almost like Zoom has been this concierge. Like, you know me, like I love wingmaning people. I love introducing people because I people don't do that for themselves. And everyone's like, could you do my commercial? And I'm like, well, I can't. I've got to do my own commercial, but I don't mind introducing you. But it's almost like Zoom is warming them up. And this requirement, this has been, self-quarantine has been a boon for us getting these people out from behind the camera. And then when you go over there and shoot them, it's just an extension of that. So I am also happy for that. So real quick, before we wrap up and get this thing posted for everybody, what one piece of advice from your perspective, whether that's a marketing guy or production guy, you have so many talents, what is the one piece of advice you find yourself giving everybody as you encounter them given this context?
I've definitely been leaning into more and more video. To bring up Marcos very quickly, you know, we did – I don't know if you saw it. It was sometime last week. We did, it was Wednesday actually of last week. They were closed Tuesday, Wednesday. They reopened Thursday, just like this week. But last Wednesday, we did a full hour long masterclass on Facebook Live with Marcos. And I mean, it was wonderful. We had, within an hour, we had nearly 600 views.
Wow.
Right.
Wow. So, I noticed Lakeland Live went live again too with Nathan Fleming.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And they were live for like an hour and 40 minutes, but I'm seeing this very good. 600
Correct.
People.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
And how many people wouldn't have been exposed to the brand in the first place.
Correct. Yeah. Because people are home and you said it just right, that the self-quarantine, the stay at home is forcing people to be in front of these more. To be in front of their TVs, to all in front of digital devices of some shape and size, you know, probably a rectangle of some kind. That, you know, the numbers don't lie. People are, the sharing is easier. I'll even just say very quickly that the ads, you know, we run really good ads, you know, normally, I think like 70 something, 80 something cents a click, you know, is usually what I can get for an ad. Now I'm seeing 25 cents a click.
Come on.
For the same budget, same budget. Okay.
But so we're going to turn that into a commercial. To those of you watching who have ever thought about doing pay-per-click ads with anyone, talk to Chris Hinojosa. We'll post his contact. Talk to Light Up Digital Marketing. That's pretty impressive. I mean, I don't know if you guys know, but that's an impressive improvement. That's pretty crazy.
But this is and I appreciate the plug. I wasn't even thinking about that.
Sure.
I mean, there's been so many business owners who have for years now been on the fence. Should I run Facebook ads or should I run Google ads or YouTube ads? Now is the definite time to do that because your marketing dollars will go further.
Go further. Yeah.
They just will.
And you don't have to be like, you don't have to be self-aggrandizing in that. Your ads can be
correct.
Just messaging ads for now. Brand exposure. Yes. We're here to serve. We love you. It doesn't have to be these performance-based clicks, and it's still good ad spend. I saw a killer article that said, you know, big companies were slashing marketing budgets by 50%, 80%. And that's true. But what no one's saying is they're also slashing other budgets within the company.
Yes.
And then they're reconfiguring back into marketing, but with a messaging voice. I can't say how quickly some of these big Toyota commercials turned around. Who's the guy? The travel, I think it's travelocity.com, Captain Obvious or whoever he is, shot a commercial and have pivoted. Like that takes a huge amount of effort. And so the marketing dollars are pivoting. So for you mom and pop store who have toyed with the idea, if you just have $100, your ad spend will go further and you can be present. So I really appreciate that. Okay, one last time, everybody. This is Chris with Hinojosa. He's been partnering with Light Up Digital Marketing. They together have collabed to roll out supportlakeland.com. It's an app for you to support. And I mean, you're getting a service, you're getting your food, but for those restaurant owners who want to make a quick pivot, check out supportlakeland.com. We'll post links down there. Chris, thank you for what you're doing. Thank you for your time.
Thank you for having me on.
Absolutely. And we'll post links down below. Thanks, everyone. Till next time. This is Grant, and here's to you igniting your own life on this plus significant.